Achieving success in the upcoming lunar race is a primary goal for every entity. However, this competition has intensified dramatically, with many formidable participants entering the arena. Hypothetically, SpaceX currently holds the lead in the race regarding deadlines. Despite this, many still doubt their ability to achieve their lofty aspirations. In difficult times, SpaceX has consistently adopted bold and innovative strategies. A notable example is their approach to improving and expanding their manufacturing systems to ensure not only their own success, but also a major victory for the United States in lunar exploration. So, what specific strategies is SpaceX using to prepare for its lunar initiative, and how do these improvements give them a substantial advantage over their competitors? Let's discuss it all in today's episode of NR Studio. As we approach the final months of 2025, humanity's efforts to return to the moon are entering a crucial phase. The race is fierce, with various countries and organizations tirelessly striving to achieve the next monumental advancement in space exploration. For the United States, the anticipated return of astronauts to the lunar surface will be highlighted by the groundbreaking Artemis 3 mission, which will rely on SpaceX's Starship Human Landing System, often referred to as HLS. Following this mission, follow-up operations will feature future iterations of HLS alongside Blue Origin's lunar lander. Meanwhile, on the other side of the world, China is moving forward with its own ambitions to send astronauts to the moon using two different rockets, one intended for a space probe and one for a lunar lander. In terms of timeframes, Artemis 3 appears to have the upper hand in this competition. However, this advantage comes with obstacles that make mission timelines unpredictable. Among these obstacles, the creation of SpaceX's orbital refueling system is notable as one of the most challenging. This requires not only a series of successful demonstrations in space, but also the fabrication of multiple Starship prototypes to perfect the procedures. Despite these obstacles, SpaceX continues to progress rapidly. The company's unwavering commitment to innovation and expanding its capabilities is evident in every aspect of its operations, particularly in its production processes. The inauguration of the Star Factory marks the beginning of a new chapter in Starship manufacturing. Within this expansive facility, SpaceX has demonstrated its capacity to mass-produce critical components such as nose cones, tanks, and ring sections. This progress is crucial as the company prepares for the mass production needed to facilitate refueling and other missions. However, production cannot be achieved simply by component fabrication. Each component must be assembled through a stacking process, culminating in a fully integrated Starship. This is where one of SpaceX's latest and most daring endeavors, the Gigabay, becomes relevant. The Gigabay has been under consideration since the beginning of the year, with development sites in progress at both Starbase in Texas and Cape Canaveral in Florida. At Starbase, construction commenced with site preparation and foundational work, which has since been finished. The subsequent phase, which involves vertical construction, has already begun. Recently, SpaceX utilized a crane to position a large steel framework at the Gigabay site, marking the onset of the principal structural construction. The design of these steel structures indicates that SpaceX may be adopting a novel construction method. Each frame appears to be a modular section of a tower that can be elevated to support a crane system. This crane mechanism will feature long horizontal arms connected to a mobile base unit. The design permits the base unit to move upwards as new tower sections are incorporated below it, facilitating construction to rise higher without requiring numerous cranes of varying sizes. This type of system offers considerable benefits. It presents nearly limitless height capabilities, reduces the necessity for additional heavy machinery, and accelerates the construction process significantly. For a structure as immense as Gigabay, which is anticipated to reach about 116 meters in height, with even greater width and depth, this strategy could revolutionize construction methods. It not only conserves time, but also sets the stage for larger constructions that SpaceX plans to undertake in the future. Naturally, there remains the chance that the steel framework observed may indeed be part of Gigabay's main structural framework, rather than just a support for construction activities. Should that be the case, we can look forward to additional steel sections appearing soon as SpaceX continues to build the facility incrementally. Regardless of the interpretation, one fact is certain. The construction of the primary framework has officially commenced, representing a significant advancement in the expansion of the Starship program's facilities. In light of the current progress and in comparison to prior initiatives like the Megabay, it is conceivable that Gigabay could be finished by the close of next year. However, with SpaceX's increasing expertise and efficiency, the facility might be operational even by mid-2026. Once finalized, Gigabay will act as the foundation for the next developmental phase of SpaceX. Its fast dimensions will enable the assembly of as many as 10 or even 20 Starship and Super Heavy prototypes at once. This marks a major improvement over the Megabay, which presently accommodates only 4 or 5 vehicles simultaneously. Such capability will be vital for fulfilling SpaceX's ambitious refueling objectives. Early in the coming year, the company aspires to demonstrate crucial milestones, such as orbital insertion, payload deployment, and the successful landing of both rocket stages.
Once the stated goals are achieved, attention will shift to the development and showcase of the in-space refueling mechanism that will facilitate missions to the Moon and other planets. Achieving this requires a consistent and large-scale output of Starships, needed for both fueling tankers and experimental models. The increased dimensions of the upcoming Starship V3, along with the necessary vehicle production volume, highlights Gigabay's essential role in this endeavor. Its improved capabilities will allow SpaceX to swiftly build, test, and refine new designs, overcoming the limitations experienced in the past. Numerous members of the aerospace sector have raised doubts about whether the refueling mechanism can genuinely be realized in such a limited timeframe. Nevertheless, the swift development of Gigabay indicates that SpaceX recognizes the challenge and is actively tackling it through thoughtful expansion. Ultimately, Gigabay's success might influence whether Starship's timeline to lunar exploration stays on track. Upon its completion, SpaceX will acquire the manufacturing strength needed to produce numerous Starships, which will support moon missions and initiate the journey toward Mars exploration and further. So, what are your views? Will the swift advancements at Gigabay become pivotal in SpaceX's quest to the Moon and Mars? Share your opinions in the comments below. Is Gigabay the essential element for Starship's future breakthrough? In addition to Gigabay and the production framework, SpaceX is continuously working on enhancing several other vital sites. A significant example is the Massey Test Facility, which is recovering rapidly following the mid-year event that momentarily halted its functions. The facility is now displaying evident signs of resurgence, starting with the installation of 2 new cryogenic test platforms. These developments mark an initial move toward restoring Massey's testing abilities and will likely be succeeded by the reintroduction of static fire systems. Once these systems are back online, they will be crucial in accommodating SpaceX's rising testing frequency, which is essential for the company's aim for quicker development timelines. Furthermore, Massey is already conducting a series of test tank assessments. These tests are not standard. They are important preparations for the forthcoming V3 prototype, which signifies the next major step in Starship's advancement. The V3 Starship will debut with Flight 12, initiating a new, more dynamic phase for the program with stronger materials, enhanced design effectiveness, and improved performance. The V3 Starship is anticipated to be a significant component in the future lunar missions as part of NASA's Artemis initiative. Meanwhile, advancements are also being made in launch infrastructure. At Starbase, Pad 2 is steadily approaching completion.
The enhanced OLM and newly constructed fire trench have been designed for long-term use, equipped to accommodate the next-generation Starship vehicle. Pad 1 is also expected to undergo a major redevelopment soon, ensuring both launch pads can support increased launch frequency. These upgrades will enable SpaceX to execute missions more regularly, safely, and effectively, strengthening its readiness for future lunar exploration. Simultaneously, SpaceX's expansion efforts in Florida are accelerating. The company is building a robust new operations center there, starting with a launch facility at LC-39A and eventually including an additional location at SLC-37. Additionally, new production and test sites, including the anticipated Gigabay Florida, will be established to bolster this growing network. Unlike Starbase, the Florida system may play a more crucial role in the lunar race as it is closely tied to NASA's mission oversight and management. This expansion not only enhances SpaceX's operational capabilities, but also strategically positions the company at the center of America's revitalized mission to the Moon. SpaceX's significant enhancements to the Starship initiative create a pathway to a future where the organization could potentially leave its competitors far behind. Observing Blue Origin often reveals immaculate facilities and meticulously crafted presentations. However, their internal progress remains ambiguous, creating an air of uncertainty. For several years, they have faced challenges due to limited launch hardware availability, which has hampered their progress. Currently, that momentum has not shown substantial improvement. While they have launched prototypes on their last two missions, it remains unclear whether they can maintain readiness as launch frequency increases. Their situation is compounded by their obligation to supply BE-4 engines for ULA's Vulcan rocket, which has diverted their resources and attention. As a result, Blue Origin has only completed one orbital mission to date. This inconsistent progress puts them at a disadvantage in the lunar race, especially when compared to SpaceX's steady pace of testing, refinement, and rapid development. Meanwhile, China is a broader strategic competitor to both SpaceX and the United States in the race to reach the lunar landscape. On the surface, China's progress in aerospace technology appears steady, bolstered by strong government support and growing ambition. Their manufacturing and testing resources are vast, and their initiatives are meticulously executed and long-term. However, compared to the agility and speed of SpaceX's Starship program, China still lags behind. State-built rockets in China are largely conventional in design, complex, expensive, and non-reusable. Although new private companies have emerged, many of their rockets appear to copy the designs of SpaceX and other industry leaders, demonstrating a lack of innovation and technological independence. That's all for today's episode. See you in the next time.